back in the house!
Did you say deja vu?
When you're NWO, you're NWO for life. So Scott and I, we had been in WCW prior to our careers in New York, and both of us felt we were treated poorly, and we had a lot to prove, and we figured the best way to do it was just come in and take over the company. So that was basically the essence of the NWO, and when we were able to get Hollywood to join us, it pretty much put the exclamation point on the NWO. The big concern at that point was, going back and looking, is who was the third person? We're going to have a six-man tag against WCW's finest, and we knew that in order to once again make a point, the third guy had to be stronger in the people's eyes than the first two that came out. I think it was a big surprise when Scott walked on the television show. It was a big surprise when I walked on the show, and then when Hogan turned in Daytona Beach, it was just kind of wow. And I think that ignited pro wrestling to what we have now with the incredible cable ratings and everything else. I think it would pretty much shock the world that the perennial good guy in pro wrestling had became evil. Scott and I had not tagged before coming here. We had no prior ring experience with each other, and at that point we'd had, you know, a good run together here, and I mean Harlem Heat had been, I don't know, 6-time world tag champs, so I knew we could pretty much get the job done against them. I thought that talent wise we were far superior to them, and by gosh, we had a big victory, didn't we?
What we do have a lot more concerning one Rowdy Roddy Piper and Hollywood Hulk Hogan as we are set to go. It's not Squire David Taylor's music.
Oh, well, wait a minute.
The new world order. See ya. Well, wait a minute. Stay right here. Eric Bischoff. Vincent, Paul and Nash and Six. They just walk in wherever they want to go.
Well, they promised to take over Nitro. Is tonight the night?
I'm back!
What a pretty picture.
Well, I knew that I had to find something to do after my wrestling career, so I thought I'd go ahead and get a little practice and courtesy of WCW, and Scott and I took over with Eric, and I think we called almost 2 hours one night. I believe it was at that point maybe the highest rated Nitro ever, and it wasn't the match quality, I think it was just basically Scott and I.
And me, with the World Tag Team Champions, you gotta love this.
You know, Ric Flair, even to this day, he continually preaches this traditionalism thing that, you know, wrestling has roots and everything else, and I mean, Scott and I have the philosophy that wrestling is not about tradition, it's about money.
If you don't like the NWO, that's fine. Two great athletes hold the World Tag Team title. That's all in that. Two great icon athletes want them. That's really what it's all about here tonight at the Great American Bash.
And they'll do anything they can to hold on to those titles. And Flair and Piper will do anything they can to take it from them.
He'll send Flair to the other corner. Flair upside down, walk the apron right to the big foot of Kevin Nash. Sending Flair to the far, then near side. Picks him up. Look at this. Look at the power. Oh, my God!
There he goes. Come on, baby. Got your deal on him.
Nash holding, just pounding down. And oh, Piper.
Oh, man.
Is up to the... Look at Piper.
Take the big man down. I'm telling you.
Oh! Back of the head, big foot. Piper goes down.
Six cut him with a reverse kick right there in the back of the head.
And down goes Six. Flair going after Six. You talk about hatred. Look at this. Flair is fighting Six outside of the ring.
But I tell you what, Piper's late in the middle of that ring and a lot of serious injury.
I think Flair's forgotten what match he did.
Oh, man. now they got a cover.
Here it is. One, two, three.
Wow.
They are still the tag team champions.
I think of all the things I've done in the 10 years I've been a professional wrestler, without a doubt, the one highlight of my career was being able to play Arn Anderson. A lot of people don't realize I was nominated for 7 Emmys on that, and was eked out by, I think it was Joe Mannix.
The day you leave your livelihood and there's someone standing next to you with a tear in their eye, you're a lucky man, because, buddy, at the end of this road, if there's one person in the world you can say is your friend, that is for life.
I'll give you the only thing I got left. I'll give you my...
Come on, Fordy! And I'm taking the NWO...
The most pathetic display of all.
And I'm putting them in.
Actually, what happens, we actually knock the skin loose on Ric Flair, and as you see now, that he's still suffering. A giant had ran his mouth for a long time, and as far as I'm concerned, you know, there's only one giant in professional wrestling, that's Kevin Nash. I mean, he can wear lifts in his shoes and say he's the giant, but on that given night, when it came down to it, I think everyone knows why the moniker Big Sexy, the quote, giant killer, was born. After that powerbomb, I was immediately asked to do a series of strongman contests because of the incredible feat of lifting a 600-pound beast.
Effective immediately, right now, the jackknife powerbomb, or any version of it, is now barred at WCW. And Kevin Nash, if you ever attempt to execute that move again on another wrestler, WCW will have you not only fined and disqualified in the match, but we'll have you escorted out of the building, and WCW will explore the possibilities of criminal prosecution.
We have been a target of WCW. You, my friend, have been singled out by J.J. Dillon.
Another attempt at WCW to curtail my performances, to try to hold me back, and you know, with Hogan's incredible amount of wealth, he came to me and said, you know, go ahead, continue to do it, and I'll pay the fines, and we continue to do it.
Now, while Bischoff, Hogan, DiBiase, Vincent are all up there at Rodman's little opening day movie shenanigans, we're here taking care of business. So you boys in Chicago, if you're watching, you better get focused. So I'll tell you something right now. I'm getting pissed off. I'm getting tired of sitting around having you guys take my time. I'll tell you right now, you don't want to get me mad, because I'm one person in this business that can stand alone. You're the true giants. And if you got a problem with me or any of the decisions made in NWO, I want to hear the rest of it right now.
Well, it seems to me that we've got a little problem about trust going on right now.
We've got a major argument right now. Look at the face of Kevin Nash.
Well, whatever Hogan is saying, Nash isn't buying it.
Well, brother.
Take heed to what Macho Man says.
behind you, there may be one, or there may be many, waiting to stick a knife in your back.
Uh-oh. A lot of people behind him, too.
You don't have to worry about me, because I'll shoot you right between the eyes.
I say that I'm going to introduce to you right now the new leader of the NWO, Big Sexy Kevin Nash.
Kevin Nash, Big Sexy. Pretty cool. Cool under pressure. He's got a lot to give this sport. Pretty impressed. That's why I anointed him the leader of the NWO, the Rebel Gang, the Wolfpack.
The most profound statement we have heard in many, many years here on the program. The world champion says he's the new leader of the NWO.
Hogan, you wondered who was going to drive a stake through your heart? Well, buddy boy, you're looking at him. It's over. Book closed. End of the story. Have a nice life.
Kevin Nash, intelligent, witty, you know, one of the brighter, more creative minds in wrestling. Very temperamental. He's the type of guy that you always got to, you know, be on your P's and Q's because he dishes it out, but he can't take it sometimes. You know what I'm saying?
I think Kevin's a real innovator. You know, he's one of the first big white guys who I thought was really cool. It's hard to be big and big, tall and white and be cool. And Kevin's one of those guys that's pulled it off because he is. He's real, you know. He played basketball at Tennessee, and he was a great basketball player, and he just has a coolness about him that people like.
Kevin Nash is another innovator, another creative guy. Real smart, funny, talented. Has a lot to offer for wrestling and could probably branch off and he could probably write his own sitcom. He is real witty. I think that he, along with Scott Hall, changed WCW when they first came in here. I think they're responsible for that.
Well, Scott and I have been great friends now for almost 8 years, and I mean, there were some problems, and his problems were that of a personal, you know, weren't anything that was professionally or in a business sense. And, you know, I'm his closest friend, and always have been, and he had to work through that. And that was just something that he had to do. It was his, you know, and I was there for him.